Okay, student, today we will discuss the concept of three-level architecture schema mapping. In last video, we discussed the basic concept of the three-level architecture. We discussed the three different level: external level, conceptual level, and internal level in three-level architecture. Now we are having the concept of the schema mapping. What is a schema mapping? We see that schema mapping is actually the link between two level is established by the schema mapping. So the whenever we are creating the link between two different level, so that is established by the schema mapping. So when we see that we are having the concept of the schema mapping, data item or object of the one level interact with the object of the other level, that concept is called schema mapping. If we checked it over here, we are having a three level architectures: external level, conceptual level, and internal levels. So whenever we are having the link between external level and conceptual levels, or we are having the link between conceptual level and internal levels, so data item of one level that interact with the object of another level, that concept is called schema mapping. When we say that we are having the schema mapping, we are having the two main type of the schema mapping. First one, we see that we are having the conceptual internal schema mapping. When we see that conceptual internal schema mappings, or we see that external, sorry, first let me discuss about the external conceptual schema mapping, then we see that conceptual internal schema mappings. Conceptual external or external conceptual schema mappings create a link between the external levels and conceptual levels. Whenever we are having the links between external levels and conceptual levels, so that link is called, creation of that one link is called external conceptual schema mappings. Specification, let me see that specifying the mapping object in the external view to those in the logical data model, that is called external conceptual schema mapping. Next one, we are having the conceptual internal schema mappings. Create a link between the conceptual level and internal level. That concept is called conceptual internal schema mappings. So in other words, we see that specify mapping between objects in the logical model to those in the physical model. So what is the logical model? Conceptual schema, that will be considered as a logical data model, and the internal schema is considered as a physical data model. So whenever we are specifying the mapping between the object of the logical data model to those in the objects of the physical data model, that concept is called conceptual internal schema mappings. Okay, now we are having if we checked here, create the link between the external and conceptual, that is called external conceptual mapping, and create a link between the conceptuals and internal, that is called conceptual internal schema mapping. Now what are the outcomes of three-level architecture? That is the data independency. We see in the advantages of database that we are having the concept of the data independency. We are having the separations of file description with data or application programs. That is called data independency. File descriptions, metadata stored separately, while application program are the stored separately. Now three level architecture is the main outcome of three level architecture, that is we say that three level architect outcome of three level architecture, that is data independency. We are having the two different type of the data independencies are here. First one, we say that logical data independencies. Sorry for drawing the wrong. Okay, logical data independency. And logical data independency, we say that change in the conceptual model does not affect the external whenever user are making at the conceptual view, conceptual schema, that does not affect the external view. Logical data independency is the resistance of external schema to change in the conceptual schema. Like when we see that we are having the logical data independency, we user is adding the new file, adding any new field to any file, changing the type of the attribute, or deleting the attribute. So whenever user is making the change in the conceptual schema, that does not affect the external schema. Second one, we are having the physical data independency. Physical data independency means whenever user want to make the change in the lower level, that is the internal levels, changing in the internal model do not affect the conceptual data model. Physical data independency is the resistance of the conceptual schema to change in the internal schema. Let me say that whenever user want to make change in the file descriptions, file organizations, index implementation, that will never ever affect the conceptual schema. That is about the data independency. We already discussed about the logical data independency and the physical data independency. Thanks for watching the video.